Good morning everybody, welcome to Arjun Education. So in this video we are going to learn about friction. So in this video I am going to explain you for class 8 science CBSE chapter number 12 friction. So now let us start. So now friction, now you know friction. Now I will give you some small, without starting this friction, I will give you one small example. Like you know carom board. Now when you play carom board, so when you hit a coin, so it goes and it stops, okay, because of friction. Okay, now let us start our chapter. So now a bicycle, a man is cycling. So from the backwards, the man is cycling towards the right side, and from the back side another man comes and pushes the cycle, and the cycle moves ahead more fast. Okay, so this is one. And in the other case, the cycle is moving to the right hand side, but this time, in this case, the man is pushing the cycle to left hand side. Okay, means the cycle is moving here to right hand side, and the man which is standing, he is pushing to left hand side. So will the cycle will move slower, and finally it stops. So now you know cricket. Okay, I know that many of them see the cricket matches. So in that, the batsman hits a ball. So that ball goes to the boundary. So now this is here is the boundary. Now the ball comes here, it becomes slow down, and finally stops. It does not touch the boundary. Okay, this is an example like a ball hit by the batsman, the force applied by the batsman. And now the on the ground, okay, when the ball comes and attaches with the ground, okay, and when it attaches with the ground, the ball's speed which is there, it's slower, it becomes slow, and finally it stops. So you can write, if the force is applied on the direction of the motion, it speeds up. Okay, now the force is, now in the bicycle case, in which now if the force by the man in the first case was applied to the direction of the motion in which the motion was going, the man applied the force on that direction only, so the cycle moved front. So you can write this definition: if the force is applied on the object in the direction of the motion, it speeds up. Okay, now in the second case, the man was pushing to the left hand side and the bicycle was moving to right hand side. So now for this you can write, the force applied on an object opposite of the direction of the motion. Okay, now the force is applied, here I have wrote the definition: if force is applied on an object of direction of the motion, opposite of direction of motion, it slows down and gradually stops. Okay, so now in the second case, in the bicycle was moving and the man was stopping it, trying to push to the opposite side. So here the bicycle driven moves front and gradually stops. So this is the definition, perfect definition: if the force is applied on the opposite direction of the motion, it slows down and gradually stops or eventually stops. Okay, now this was for the second case. Now there are such many examples, not only in cricket and carom, there are such many examples. Like take an table. Now here is a table. So now there is a box given here. So if you push that box, okay, if you apply the force on the box will move and it finally stops. Now I'll give you an example. So now here is imagine here is a table, okay, and here is the box, and which you have applied force on here, it moves ahead and it moves forward and it slows down and it finally stops here. Now this, we applied force from here to move that side to our right hand side like this, but the friction which is stopping the cube from here. Okay, which is the friction is doing the opposite. The force is applied on an object of the direction of the opposite direction of the motion. So this friction, this is called as friction. Now if I am moving here, means my leg is attached to the ground. Okay, so now when I move, I need to apply little force, because there is a friction present on the ground, and our feet attraction which stops me, but I need to move forward because I need to go there. So I applied more force to move. Now you can take another example, like this is a pen. Okay, so on my hand I keep here and I do like this. So now this pen's this part surface is attaching to my hand surface. Now here when I push the pen, then only it moves forward. If I keep like this, will it move? No. Well, when I do like this, then only it will move. If my hand is like this and the pen is like this, will it move? No, because there is no force applied to form friction. Now here I force it. I give it force. No, you know the force when we apply it, then only friction is generated. So when you push the pen towards here, the friction will push here. Okay, this depends on my force. So now this is about friction. Now the direction of friction. Now what is the direction of the friction? Now let us know. So now here is now this is a table. Now here is an another cube. Now here I showed you this cube is pushed, is given a force to move our right hand side. So when it moves, the friction force is towards left hand side. Now here we push, now here there is another cube, and when we push it, it comes here. So the force is applied towards here. Okay, the force is the force up to the cube is applied here, but the friction here will apply to here. So now whatever object, now if an object is moving towards the right hand side, the friction will try to stop it from the friction will move to left hand side. Okay, the opposite of the force. Now if an object is moving to left hand side, the friction will try to push it in the right hand side. Okay, so now this is the direction of the friction. Now friction acts in the direction opposite to the direction of motion. Okay, this I explained you right now. This I am explaining because some children get confused and do mistakes in this. So please be careful. Now another, the cause of friction. Now here I have given the one important definition, like friction force is caused due to the interlocking of the regular on the surface of two objects in contact irregularly. Now if you see a table that will be smooth, and even the cube which you kept on the table is the surface is this flat smooth, but when you zoom it and in the microscope, then you will see that this is a table. Okay, so the table will have like this small holes. Okay, the table is having like this small holes. Only when you will zoom it in microscope, you cannot see with your naked eyes. So the table is having like this small holes, which is too minute. And this block is also having some small holes. Now this small holes come in contact. Now they both come here. They both come in contact and they got locked here like this. Okay, you can see. So now if this is the block and this is the surface, now this block has to move forward. So it will have some force. It needed to have some force. Now this holes like this. This is a hole on the table. So that is why when block move, it now this gappings. these holes come in contact with each other, and this is called as irregularities. Okay, which I have given here, irregularities. Now, friction force is caused due to the interlocking. Now, this interlocking, this because of this interlocking, the friction is caused. Okay. Now I'll give you one more example. Now this was same to the cricket case also. When the ball moves, the friction is applying to the opposite of the. Wait, I'll explain you more clearly. So now here is the here there is ground, and the ball here is attached to the seam. Now this ball is also having like this. Okay, it looks very smooth, but when you zoom in the microscope, it is having like this small holes. So this ball comes in the contact with ground, means it attaches to the ground, means like this it attaches. So it is having more force by the batsman who hit the ball. So it will go ahead, it will become slow here, it will become slow, and it will finally stop. Okay, this was same. So now you know carom board. Now in the carom board, when you have not powdered, you shoot a coin with the striker. What will happen? It will move till small certain. It will move to certain area. Now here is the carom board, and from the striker you hit a coin here, so it will move till here with a certain distance, because the coin which is there, it is also having the same holes with the contact with the board. The board is also having the same holes like the table and also the coin. So now they also interact with each other. So when it is difficult to move the coin faster, now when you want to play more easily, so you spray powder. Yes, you spray powder. Now after powdering, if your striker is here and you hit the coin, so this coin will move in the such a speed and come here. It comes back, or it can come to any direction, but it moves very fast. Now in the previous case, when it was not powdered, it stopped till here only, but now the coin is coming till here. Why? Now you know that in the table there are some holes, and in the cube also. Now in the same case with carom board, the coins is having the same, and the board is also having the same. Now when we powder, now the powder fill in the holes. Okay, which fill in the holes. Okay, so here when you will see. Here this is a coin. Now if you will do like if the it is having like this holes, the board. Now here there's the coin is here. Now this both will come in contact and will come like this, right? Now we add powder so that this holes is filled with the powder and they cannot interlock. Okay, if there is very low friction, so they cannot interlock properly. So they will stand like this, so that they can move more faster. Because of that only the coins can move more faster to more distance. Okay. I hope that you have understood what is friction clearly. What is the cause of friction, and what is the direction of friction? Okay. So please, if you like our video, please like. Please subscribe our channel Education. Also click on the bell icon to get more views. And please also share this video to your friends, natives, cousins, and all your family mates. Bye-bye.